click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have talked about the molecular orbital diagram for the neon molecule, and we are going to talk about basically molecular orbital diagram for that is boron molecule. So let us understand. So talking about the molecular orbital diagram for the boron molecule, the first thing that we have to do is we have to represent the atomic orbital diagram for that is the boron atom, and then only we would be able to draw the molecular orbital diagram for the boron molecule. So the thing that we should know how can we represent the electronic configuration of boron. So that is what we are going to do here. That is talking about the boron. Boron has an atomic number of 5. So we could write the electronic configuration as 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. So this is what we have. And talking about the subshell, so this S subshell consists of only one orbital, while the P subshell that consists of basically 3 orbitals. And now let us fulfill the electrons. So therefore there is 2 electrons that is being present in the 2s orbital, and so there is 2 electrons that is being present in the 2s orbital and 1 electron that is being present in the px orbital, if you would say that manner. So this is what we have. And talking about the further thing, so let me represent it over here as 2px, this is 2py, and this is 2pz, that is what we have, and this is what we can do. So now this is somewhere different from that of what we have did earlier. How let me represent with the help of the molecular orbital diagram, and then it will be very easy for us to understand that why it is showing that kind of molecular orbital with a particular energy level. So this is what we have represented of for one that is boron atom. So similarly the other boron atom will also have the same electronic configuration, will have the same orbitals that we have represented over here, and that is what we are going to draw the molecular orbital diagram for the boron molecule. So atomic orbitals, actually it represents the energy level, so that is what I am representing over here, that it will represent the energy level for different orbitals. That is, since we are talking about the atomic orbital of boron atom, so that is, it will have basically 3 levels over here. That is, one is for 1s, the next is for 2s, and lastly for 2p. So similarly, this is what we have represented about the atomic orbital of boron. So similarly, in another also, we have to represent the atomic orbital of boron. So this is atomic orbital of boron atom that I am representing over here. So again, it will have the same energy level for 2s, and similarly for 2p also it will be the same. So this is what I will represent for basically boron atom. And let's talk about the orbitals. So 1s, it consists of basically one orbital, and here also it is one orbital for 2s and for 1s. And talking about 2p orbital, it consists of the 2p subshell, it consists of 3 orbitals, so therefore 1, 2, 3, here also 3 orbitals that are present over here. So talking about fulfilling the electrons, so let us fulfill the electrons according to the Erbos principle and according to the Hund's multiplicity rule. So therefore this is 2 electrons that are present over here. Again, the 2s consists of 2 electrons and the 2p consists of basically 1 electron. So I am representing over here in this way. So let me designate this orbitals also. So therefore this is 2px, that is what we know. This is 2py and this is 2pz. So similarly here also it is 2px, 2py, and this is 2pz, that is what we know. So now talking about the further thing that we have already removed, because this 1s orbital, obviously it is very much close to that of the nucleus of the boron atom, so that won't take part in bonding. So therefore this is what we have got over here. So this is the energy level, that is what we could call it as non-bonding atomic orbitals, and we could say that they won't form in the, they won't be responsible to give the molecular orbitals to give the bonding. So therefore this is what we are going to represent about the molecular orbital. So talking about the 2s, when 2s orbitals, that is this 2s and another 2s, they will come close to each other or they will interact with each other, again they will dissociate into 2 energy levels, and that is what we are going to represent over here. That is, the 2 energy level is one we could call it as bonding orbital, while the other one is known as antibonding orbital. And since the atomic orbitals are basically in a total of 2, so therefore the 2 molecular, new molecular orbitals will be formed, and that is what this is. And just let us compare it with the energy level. So it's just a small indication just as to represent the difference in the energy level that it has been created over here. And now let's designate that one. So therefore this could be called as sigma 2s orbital, while this is known as sigma star 2s orbital or antibonding orbital. So the total number of electrons that are present over here is 4 electrons, so therefore we could fill it according to the Abbos rule as well as according to the Hund's multiplicity rule. So therefore 1, 2, 3 and 4 electrons that are fulfilled. So now talking about the last one, that is for 2p orbitals. Again, it consists of 2px, 2py and 2pz. Again, it will be distributed in the energy levels. That is what we are going to represent over here. So usually what we think is the 2pz orbitals, that is this 2pz and this 2pz, that is responsible for forming the sigma bond. But in this case, because as we know that the 2p orbital or we could say that the 2p subshell consists of only one electron, and that's the reason that we can't find any kind of pairing in this kind of 2p orbitals, and that is the reason that the energy level of this 2s and that of the 2p, it is very much close to each other, and that is very much there is not that much of difference between these two, and that is the reason that there is a possibility that this 2s orbitals or this 2p orbital, they will form a mixing, and that's the reason that we could see, because of this small energy level gap that is between the 2s and the 2pz orbital, if we could say in that manner, then that's the reason, and that's the reason that we could say that the energy level is being distributed in such a way that we get this kind of two energy level, that is one is bonding orbital and one is antibonding orbital. But usually what we do is we represent the 2pz orbital downwards, and here that is 2px as well as 2py. But in case of boron, what is the difference is we represent, that is 2px as well as 2py that are represented in downward, that is at lower energy level, while this is the 2pz orbital, while here also it will be, we see 2px and 2py, and here it will be 2pz. So this is the difference that it creates, and that is how we could see that the difference between this sigma star 2s and this, that is a sigma, that is pi 2pz, it will have a difference between them, and that's the reason that they don't get mixed with each other. But overall, the molecule's energy, it will remain the constant for atomic orbital that we could see over here, and that is what we are comparing it with. So let me just indicate that is the energy level difference with that of the original atomic orbital in such manner. So this is what we have got the difference over here, and let me designate those molecular orbitals also. So therefore this is known as basically sigma 2px, and this is known as sigma 2py, and this one would be called as, that is, so this is what we have, that is pi 2px and pi 2py, while this one would be basically sigma 2pz, that is what we know. And similarly here also we could write it in that way, that is pi star 2px, and this one would be pi star 2py. While it would, over the highest energy level, it would be basically sigma star 2pz. So this is how the energy level they get distributed with each other. And now let us fulfill the electrons over here. So therefore the total number of electrons that are present in the 2p orbital is basically 2. So how can we fulfill it? We can fulfill it according to the Abbos principle and according to the Hund's multiplicity rule. So this is the one, two electrons that we have to fill over here. So therefore this is the one electron that we have, but we can't make another electron to be added over here. So obviously we have to make the electron towards the another orbital that it has. So if you observe the overall molecular orbital, so therefore this is the molecular orbital that we have, and this is what I'm representing over here, that is the molecular orbital for boron molecule, that is B2 molecule. So according to the energy level that we could see, that 1s orbital will have the lower energy than compared to that of the sigma 2s, then sigma star 2s, and here it will be basically sigma, that is pi 2px as well as pi 2py, they will both have the same energy level, and sigma 2pz, it will have higher energy level compared to that of this two. If you would observe, then sigma that is pi star 2px and pi star 2py, they will have the same energy level, while sigma star 2pz, it will have the higher energy level, and this is how the energy level is now being distributed. So now let us talk about the electronic configuration. So the electronic configuration for that of boron molecule can be represented over in this way, that is, if I am representing, that is this k dot k, as we know that it represents the non-bonding orbital, molecular orbital, and talking about the next of the thing, that is sigma 2s, which consists of two electrons, and again sigma star 2s, which also consists of two electrons, and then we could say that pi 2px, that consists of two electrons, and pi py that consists of two electrons, and later on that is, we could say that is this, that is 2px, it consists of one electron over here, and here also it consists of one electron. So that is what I am representing. So that's it, and this is what we have represented for the electronic configuration for boron molecule. And let us understand that what is the bond order for this one. So bond order is what we know is nothing but NB minus NA divided by 2. And if I talk about the bonding electrons, there are basically two electrons that are represented over here. So therefore 2 minus 0, because there is no antibonding orbital, antibonding electrons that are present in the orbital, antibonding orbital, so divided by 2. So therefore it is 1. So that's the reason that the boron and the boron will have basically one kind of bond, but they will have a bond that is very much like a pi bond, because that will be responsible for pi bond. So it will be a very weak bond compared to that of the other one. So this is what I am talking about. So it also indicates that the boron and the boron will have only single bond between these two, and that is the reason that we are talking about this one. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly and you have got to know various concepts behind this one. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you will share this video with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.